scoliosis with lots of pain in childhood is a little bit of a red flag for us. So oftentimes if we see our average adolescent idiopathic scoliosis patient, we may just follow them with clinical examinations and x-rays to make sure the curve's not changing as they're growing. If you come in with a tremendous amount of pain associated with your scoliosis, oftentimes we'll order more advanced imaging like MRIs and other things to make sure that there's not something we're not seeing that's causing the scoliosis. And we've diagnosed several children in the last year or two who have had other things going on that was resulting in a scoliosis, but the primary pathology was not truly adolescent idiopathic scoliosis. It was a tumor or some other condition that was causing the problem. I mean, to that point, I recently saw a young adult, she was in her early 20s, who came to us by way of her primary care physician for evaluation of back pain, and she had on x-ray a very small scoliosis. But she had tremendous back pain that didn't really match the small curve she had. So we ordered an MRI and diagnosed her with a very large pelvic tumor that was causing back pain and causing the small scoliosis that, you know, when the pelvic tumor was taken out by OBGYN, back pain went away and the scoliosis went away.